Dictionaries are a fundamental data type in the Python programming language. These are organized in memory as unordered, indexed, and mutable data structures. A data structure is an implementation that a programming language provides a programmer to store and access data efficiently. A dictionary that we use in our daily lives holds a word and corresponding meaning to the word. Similarly, here, a dictionary stores data in pairs. Dictionaries store a mapping of unique keys to values. A dictionary consists of a collection of key-value pairs. This ability of storing bivariate values in a dictionary is an important functionality in Python. What do I mean by bivariate? Bivariate implies the existence of two variables where one variable influences the other. In case of dictionaries, the key is the independent variable, while the value is the dependent variable. But it's kind of like lists. Dictionaries are much more efficient, however. This makes dictionaries in Python an excellent tool for conducting exploratory data analysis while analyzing datasets. Each key-value pair maps the keys to its associate value. You can define a dictionary by enclosing comma-separated list of key-value pairs in curly braces. A colon separates the key from its associated value. Here is a brief example of using a dictionary at the Python interpreter prompt. At the command line prompt, type the word Python. In the following interactive session, the three greater than signs represent the Python interpreter prompts. The sal.info is the name of the dictionary I'm using. Sal.info is a dictionary that holds the names of all the major cities in the USA and the average salaries of the software developers as their values. So let's say I do sal.info equal braces single quotes Austin colon 91185 comma that separates one key from the other. Close braces, enter. Now sal.info displays the contents of the dictionary. And this lists the list of cities and the respective average salaries of their software developers. To just access the salary of Boston, say, we can just call the key within square brackets. So sal.info Boston equal, and we can reset the value to 95,123. So now when we do sal.info, we notice that Boston has the new value assigned to it. Let's say we want to add a new element. So we say sal.info and add a new key of a new city, say Atlanta, and we assign a new value to it, 91,234. Now when we do sal.info, again, it prints the contents of the dictionary, including Atlanta. Notice that the keys and the values are displayed in the order they were inserted. They are all not sorted. If you remember from our previous video, the key is displayed in the order it was inserted. In this case, Atlanta shows up as the last one. Let's say I want to find the length of my dictionary. I do sal.info. It shows up as 3. If I want to delete one element, I do del. Name of dictionary, sal.info, square brackets, Atlanta. Now when I see the contents again, I notice that Atlanta no longer exists. If I do len of sal.info, I see that the length has been reduced by 1. Let's say I try to access an element that's not in the dictionary. So say I do sal.info, square brackets, Atlanta. It gives me a key error. This is Python dictionary's way of giving an error saying that particular element does not exist in the dictionary. Finally, let's say you want to flush out the dictionary, that is, clean it out and make it empty. Python gives you that ability to do that using the clear method. So sal.info dot clear. Now when I look at the contents by doing sal.info, I see it's an empty dictionary. If I do length of sal.info, I see that the length is 0. Notice the syntax. Calling a method such as clear with parentheses differs from calling a function such as length with parentheses. In clear, it's a method and the dictionary name such as salinfo and the method are connected using the dot operator where the dictionary name comes first. In a function, on the other hand, length calls the dictionary in parentheses as a parameter. Just like in lists, dictionaries have both functions and methods, making this data structure highly versatile.